أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما اللهم فقهنا في الدين آمين. So all the Arabic terminology has been used in this, all the hadith. Actually, they made the topic wise in this book called Husn-e Akhlaq, and topic wise they compile hadith in one place, and that's how we are learning. Sometimes ayahs of the Quran and sometimes hadith. And today's topic is responsibility. So al-mas'uliyatun means responsibility. So first we'll see the ayah of the Quran. It's Surah Sad, ayah number 26. Okay, it says, قال الله تعالى يا داود إنا جعلناك خليفة في الأرض فاحكم بين الناس بالحق ولا تتبع الهوى فيضلك عن سبيل الله. This is Surah Sad, ayah number 26. It says, قال الله تعالى means Allah the Exalted says. So the whole Quran, who is the writer, who is the author? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And everybody knows it came with revelation, 23 years. 13 years of Mecca and then the rest 10 years of Medina. Before migration and after migration. O Dawood, Dawood al-Islam, verily we have placed you as a successor on the earth. Who is saying? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, wa alaikum salam. We have placed you as a successor on the earth. So Allah has given that authority. Everybody knows what Dawood al-Islam has been given. Subhanallah, so much authority, power, and I'll be right back. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah the Exalted says, O Dawood al-Islam, verily we have placed you as a successor on the earth. Here it says Khalifatan. We know all what Khalifa is, successor. He has been given that authority on the earth. So judge you between men in truth and follow not your desire. It says follow not your desire. Hawa is like, you know, following your own soul, you know. Sometimes our soul says, okay, do this, do that. But even though it's there, if we say, A'udhu Billah, no, I'm not going to do that. That's how. So here it says, you are men in truth and follow not your desire for it. It will mislead you from the path of Allah. See, Khalifatan Arda, Fahkum Bainan Nasi Bil Haq. You have whatever the authority you have been given, you have to do with the Haq. Haq means truth. Whatever is assigned with the duty. وَلَا تَتَّبِيَ هَوَا فَيُدُلَّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلٍ. So here it says, do not follow your own desires. It will lead you to mislead. So don't get mislead. So even though these are the prophets and rasul, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this, do this and do not do this. It's like, you know, green signal is there, okay, you can go there, but red signal is there, no, cautious, you can't do that. That's how the things are. So here Dawood al-Islam has been given that authority and follow that. Are we authorized, like, you know, in our worldly things? Are we answerable? Yes, we are. Whatever the duty we have been assigned, whether we are doing as a teacher or whatever our role model is, whatever the thing we are doing is, we have to do with our responsibility. You can't say, okay, I'm a Muslim, I'm praying 5 times a day, but when it comes to the duty, no, I can be, you know, I can leave 30 minutes, you know, you have to do 8 hours. but you are skipping somehow 30 minutes or 1 hour. No, you can't do that. It's part of our religion. So this is the thing, like, you know, this chapter, this is the responsibility, want to show what it is. So we are talking about worldly things. What about whatever the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has assigned the duty individually, like, you know, at home. We are daughters, we are mothers, we have given so many things, right? So we have to take that responsibility also. So we are everybody is assigned the responsibility, and one day we have to give this. To whom? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are answerable. Like, you know, sometimes I have seen some parents, they keep on reminding children, oh, I did this, I did that. In a good way, it's okay. But it's not like you're humiliating and, you know, as if you are telling them you did a great job, or, you know, it's not good. Telling in a nice manner, and sometimes you have to explain to them, you know, you don't know when you were sick, I did this, you know, just to explain to them. But not, you know, just to show them, show off, like, you know, this is also a show off. And that made things negative for our children. Especially in this society, when, you know, people are talking about you, especially about the parents. Oh, Muslim? Oh, their parents? You know, you have to be careful about it. So this is the responsibility. We have to be good. And who is good? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, who is good with their family. If I am good, if my husband says I am good, if my family says I am good, then I am successful. If I am good with all the society, but except my home, it's not going to work. So first thing will start from our home. Okay, we have this responsibility, we are fulfilling it. It's not like just like a parent we are daughters also. How about our parents? Are we taking care of them? How about our husband parents? Are we taking care of them? Not means taking care of them. I'm not saying, like, you know, you have to behave like a slave, like back home how the people treat. I'm not saying that. I'm saying in a respectful manner. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't love those people who break the relationship. Khata. Break the relationship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't like. You have to join the relationship. In every matter. I know, directly we are not responsible for in-laws, but indirectly it will go. Like, you know, how our husband has to be answerable for keeping their parents happy. So automatically we go through husband. We want to keep our husband happy. So we want, and you know, we want in our home peace and harmony. Next thing comes, what is called hukuk Allah. What is the responsibility Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. For ourselves first, you know how you might have heard. So first tie your seat belt, then look for the kids or children. So first we gonna tie our seat belt first. We will keep our safety first. So if I want to keep my safety first, I'll check myself. Okay. Wama khalaqtal jinna wal insa illa liyabudun. Surah Zariyat. We have been created human and jinn for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the main root cause for creating us. Okay, we are doing all the worldly things. Plus, we have to do the, you know, prayer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now, scientists are discovering, you know, okay, this kind of exercise will heal you. This kind of posture will heal you. Like going in the sujood will help a lot. You know, whenever I go to my doctor, she says, okay, you have to do yoga, you know, regularly. I said, what happens? No, it helps you, it soothes you, it soothes your mind, and, you know, you have to keep yourself calm. I said, we have 5 times prayer, you know, we do that. And I showed the, like, whatever we do. And she said, oh, this is so good. Like, you know, sister, how the things will be. If you want to share something, go ahead and, like, because this is the first-hand experience we can have it. Does it affect, like, you know, whatever the things we are doing, and does it affect our heart, peace and tranquility?
patients. So they had two groups, they split them into two groups to do a study. One of the groups, they put them on antidepressants. And the other group, they said, no medicine, just go out and walk for an hour or 45 minutes. Every single day. And a few weeks, the results were so much better for the people who were walking than the ones who were on the medicine. Medicine will have one positive effect and a negative effect. So when you go out, you walk, it's like mind, body, emotions, you know, everything you name it. You know, you become silly. There's a hormone that's produced in your brain, which is called endorphin, and that causes gives you the sense of well-being.
Okay.
So when you walk outside and you see the nature, you are happy, and you get fresh air, and a lot of times people are walking with the brain. You just interact with them, you just hello, hi, okay, and they smile at the kids, make a comment. It just gives you an inner peace, and that helps your body's healing also. So every time you walk, believe it or not, when you come home, you're so relaxed. Your whole body, spiritually, emotionally, physically, you name it. You know, all the
Alhamdulillah.
It just has a very positive effect. So it's not just for weight loss.
Weight
loss is a good thing because that keeps you going also. But a lot of other things, medically, blood pressure goes down. When you are walking, your muscles are active and they help regulate your insulin level, which is required for your diabetes. So, you know, the sugar levels maintain, the insulin in your body is maintained. So there's a lot of positives.
Alhamdulillah.
Your muscles are active, you don't feel fast and weak, you know, lethargic, and then your mood is good. It's an overall experience. Brain, you know, it's the same thing. You are doing the same thing, you know, exercise of the body, mind, and soul.
Alhamdulillah. Jazakallah khair, sister. So here, as she mentioned, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given this gift to us. He might have said, okay, no, nothing you have to do, you know, just be there in this world and spend your time. He has given this 5 times prayer. And that too, just not sitting, like it's like a total exercise, moving your limbs, not only just moving your lips and saying something, but with your limbs also, you are doing something. So that gives you so much calmness in your heart, as she mentioned, Alhamdulillah. And as time goes by, doesn't matter what age you are, you started enjoying your prayer. And you build a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is so strong. And I noticed one more thing, like as you move on, calamities are more, but your connection is more strong. People might be thinking, oh, she is, you know, so much towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, that's good. That's no problem. That's a good sign. Instead of calling people and saying, oh, I'm having this problem, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly answers your prayer. So, Alhamdulillah, this way, your problems are solved. As she mentioned, just going for walk and also those things. We are not saying like, you know, just sit ideally. Our Islam promotes all these things. But we have misconceptions. That's ignorance. And those who have that ignorance, we have to remove those darknesses. We have to have that thing in our heart. Okay, that sister doesn't know this. Have that good thing in your mind. Don't say, oh, she's like that. No, never complain. Have you heard that light a single candle, you know, instead of complaining about the darknesses? Doesn't make any sense complaining about the darknesses. So, inshallah, here we have to take care of what are the things we have to do about huququl Allah. Not only ourselves, then our children. Even our parents also. Sometimes, I don't know about here, but in back home, like when we go in suburbs, some people, their parents, they don't pray. They don't know what is cleanliness, what we call tahara. They don't know about it. We have to educate them. It's not only in India, even in Pakistan. People, they go there and they teach the things, and you know, even shahada they don't know. This is part of our responsibility. You know, we have to teach them and try to look those avenues, because this is the only life we got. Only one life we got it. If we look those avenues, like if you are going somewhere, try to look for the thing where you can do khair, where you can earn good deeds. Earning good deeds is easy, and keep it, close. You know how we deposit the money and then we want to keep it safe. That's how, like, you know, every year we are giving zakat for that, you know, taking out the money. That's how we have to keep our good deeds. So we have to take care of our children and parents and our siblings. Sometimes, some convert is there in our community. Try to appreciate them. Try to invite in our parties. Because nobody is there for them. This is also our responsibility. So in our responsibility, there are a lot of things. It's just not like, you know, where we are working, okay, we have to work 8 hours. We can't steal anything. Stealing in sense, stealing the time. I'm not saying stealing something from the workplace. Stealing the time. That's the worst thing. I think this smell is bothering. That's okay. So, not only the time, and also whatever the thing we have assigned, we have to fulfill that. Every time, remember that Allah is looking you. Okay? So, even, you know, non-Muslims, they respect those people who pray regularly. Even if you carry hijab, they respect you. If you have beard, if they know you are Muslim and you're going to be out for prayer on Friday, they respect you. This is the part of the responsibility. Tell them, this is the thing we do. And try to give the flyer or some paper, you know, this is the thing, this is about Ramadan. These are the responsibility. We are not informing our neighbors. Neighbors know through CNN or through the news channels or the negative things. What we are doing, if somebody knows, like I'm living in their neighbor, they know, okay, this is the thing, like, you know, they are very calm people. If we start, like, for example, if we have some argument at home, I tell my husband, we have to be careful. We can't start yelling or shouting, because neighbors are after us. They know we are Muslim because we are carrying this. I don't have to tell them.
That's what I always call carrying the flag of Islam. That's my slogan.
Yes.
What does that mean in your effort, in your character, in your way of doing things, in your neighborhood, everything?
Yeah, that's true.
The flag of Islam means everything. Your behavior, how you conduct at work, which is what you're saying. For my office, we have what they call a devotional group. So they have a Bible, they have the prayer room, they have the Quran, they have, you know, things for the Jewish. But every single time, you have to make sure you're stopping everything in prayer time. And so they know it.
Oh, that's
but
so
that, what does that mean? What you're saying, they respect you for that. Juma, they know at that time the computer is off, they know who what you have to pray for. But it's all us. It depends on us.
But we shouldn't be hesitant, you know. I notice most of the time 90% we are hesitant, and because of that we are not doing religious duties. Sometimes prayer time is going and we are still thinking whether I should tell them. When just ask them, can I? Then they will give you that. Don't start praying, you know, without even asking them. That is part of our, you know, duty. We should ask them. We are doing a chapter called Responsibility.
She was going to Ramadan and she was staying in the club.
Alhamdulillah. So here we are doing this chapter called Responsibility from Husne Akhlaq. We did this book. So we are doing some chapters from this, and today's topic is responsibility. And we did one ayah from Surah Sa'd regarding Dawud al-Islam. And the next we're going to take it from Surah Qasas, ayah number 83. Qala Allah Ta'ala, tilka darul akhiratu naj'aluha lillazina la yuriduna uluwan fil ard wala fasadun wala aqibatul lil muttaqin. It means Allah the Exalted says, the home of the hereafter we shall assign to those who rebel not against the truth, with pride and oppression in the land, nor do mischief by committing crime, and the good end is for the muttaqin, the pious and the righteous person. It means that only the home of hereafter is the people who are righteous, who are muttaqin. We can't rebel, we can't be, other way around. So here it says, we assign to those who rebel not against the truth, with pride and oppression in the land, nor do mischief by committing crimes. Whenever you are assigned the authority, you have to fight against those things. It's whether it's crime or oppression, you have to fight against those things. Even, we have to respect our president. It's part of our duty. If he or she is not doing the oppression, okay? If that is so, things will be different. But here we are talking about the people who has been given authority and how they end with muttaqin. They end with muttaqin when they are given those authority and they are fulfilling it. If you want to move your chair, Sister Iram, you can you can shift here, because I know you are not making eye contact. So you can, but pride, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't like. Everybody knows that, right? Pride don't like. And oppression, we have to fight oppression, okay? If you are oppressed, Allah will listen even if you are non-Muslim. You can't oppress anyone. Allah don't like that. So we have to be careful and we have to fight back. And sometimes some people, they come with the complaint, my husband is, doing this, and, he's very hard. He's even, smacking and whatnot. Okay? Why? Why don't you stop on the first step? You have to stop the oppressed person. How? With your words, or at least, stop with them. Whenever the oppression is there, you have to stop it. Whether with your words or with your actions. You can't tell, okay, if you are doing this, okay, take the second step, take the third step. Whether it's husband or anyone, we are not stopping that. We are appreciating. We are making it as a habit. Okay, today you slap here, okay, you can slap here. No, it's not so. It's not that. You're not stopping that. You are giving your example. And many people, those who are ignorant, they say, oh, that sister, even though her husband is not good, see how she is managing? That's how we are making the example. Same thing we have seen in the community. Some, mother-in-laws, they are, they are taking advantage of the good, daughter-in-laws. It doesn't mean if somebody has fear of Allah, you're going to take advantage. What about the hereafter? Like at the time of Pulsarat, when she will say, oh, you have taken mine this, this, this. You were so bad to me. That time you have to give your good deeds. Why don't you understand in this world? I'm not against anyone. Not against any mother-in-law or any daughter-in-law. I am talking about what is right and what is wrong. Try to distinguish that. If it is wrong, please try to stop that in a good manner. You have to have that thing called hikmah. If you don't have that judgment, when to talk, what to talk, how much to talk, that's how you should know. So this is the thing we should do. And next, we're going to see one more hadith from this. It is Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma narrated that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every one of you is a guardian and will be questioned for those under him. So those under him will be questioned. The ruler is a guardian and a man is a guardian of his family. Ruler about the whole thing. But the man is a guardian of the whole family. And a woman is a guardian of her husband's house and the children. Woman is responsible for husband and the children. To all of you are guardians, and all of you will be questioned for those under you. So we all are responsible for something or the other. We'll see the Arabic. An Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma an Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala kullukum ra'i'u wa kullukum mas'oolun an ra'iyati wal umri ra'i wa rajulu ra'i ala ahli al-bayt wa mar'atu ay ra'iyatun ala bayti zawjaha wa waladihi wa kullukum ra'i wa kullukum mas'oola. So every person is responsible for something or the other. For the whole community, one person is responsible. For example, somebody is taking in charge of our country. For example, it's the president and he is taking care of the whole country. But what about our community? Somebody is there, they are taking care of, for example, in Islamic center. Somebody is responsible for the whole center and they are taking care of. What about our family? Our husband is taking care of the family. If husband is not there, wife has to take the in charge of the whole family. If husband is not there, whether divorced or died, doesn't matter. She has to take the responsibility. And then under us, there's so much responsibility. And this hadith is so important. We have to take care of the responsibility. And if we take care of the responsibility, the whole community will be good and the whole country will be good, and one country affects the other. Every person thinks about good and good will spread. If you think negatively, negative things will spread. So this is how. There are more hadith, but we have some more things we have to do. So this session will end here. Inshallah, we'll start our, every time we do dua, you remember? So this time we're going to do some small dua. Inshallah, I'll try to send the PDF. If I forget, please try to remind me. Sometimes, you know, I have so much things on my mind. If I forget, to please remind me. So today's dua is, Allahumma alhimni rushdi a'izni min sharri nafsi. It's very small dua, but it has so much, words are so good. So Allahumma, O Allah. We are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma, O Allah. Alhimni. You know, give me time. Or give me some space, you call it. Okay? Alhimni rushdi. Alhimni rushdi. A'izni. Rushdi is Rushdi, my guidance. We are asking for our guidance. Min sharri, from my nafsi, my nafs. Shar is like, you know, min sharri nafasati, the same thing, shar. From the evil things, whatever the things we are, I'm doing evil, please stop me there. And we are asking not for hidayah, we are asking for rushd. Rushd is above the hidayah. This is the one more level up. So here it's very small dua, just four, five. You know, I have in the phone also. Let me take out that. I can. Inshallah, I'll send you today that dua also. O Allah, bestow on me my rectitude and save me from the evil of my soul. This is in Tirmizi. Allahumma alhimni rushdi wa aizni min sharri nafsi. Allahumma, O Allah, alhimni rushdi, bestow on me my rectitude or my guidance, wa aizni, and save me min sharri nafsi, from evil of my soul. Yeah, I'll send in the group, inshallah. So this also, and also the previous hadith and what ayah we shared today about responsibility. So this is the thing we are asking. Why duas are so important? Because like you remember, like in morning we made morning askar, in the evening we do evening askar. This is the protection. You know, when we recite Ayatul Kursi, Yuhituna Bishayin Min Ilmihi, it encircle you. So we are encircled in the protection. So we comes in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every step we are putting it, before that we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah ta'ala, guide me in the right way. Because we don't know, when we start today, like first thing in the morning, we start this thing and we do askar prayer. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is guiding you in a right way. So these are the du'as will help you go in a right manner. Sometimes you are confused, oh, whether I should do this or do this. You know, that time these things will help you. So try to memorize these du'as. Only 4 or 5 words are there. Allahumma alhimni rushdi wa'izni min sharri nafsi. I'll send you in Sister Asma's voice. Her voice is so good, and the way she spells the words are so clear. You can hear the ayin is clear, hamza is clear. So clearly she mentions everything, alhamdulillah. And I know, like tajweed class, Sister Lamia is there for teens. She can't come to every class. She has her kids are very small. She can't come. So today in our class we're gonna do some of the tajweed, inshallah. This is the small dua. We'll keep it this way, and inshallah we have 15 more minutes, because at 12 we start our tafsir session. So everybody knows about izhar letters. Do you know what is izhar? In tajweed is like, you know, whatever, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the Quran, and our sahaba and our prophet, how they recite it. There are 7 ahru, 7 ways of reciting it. So we can follow any one way, but it should be in a right manner. So we are following tajweed rules so that our recitation should be good. It should be beautiful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will listen to the people who recite so well. So we want to be among the people who recite well. Remember that hadith, like, you know, when you die, a handsome person is with you and you keep asking, who is this, who is this? And it replies, oh, I am the person. You remember, you used to recite Quran. So Quran can be in your favor or it can be against you. Do you want to put in the tower and put in the shelf and you don't want to read it? No. That will fight you. It will be against you. You want to read it again and again. I notice all my teachers, they have their mushaf in the bag. Every time, whether bag is small or big, I notice, I learn things from them immediately. Like, you know, every time they have mushaf. Even they are in parking lot, they say, okay, Afreen, do you have your mushaf? I want to know how you recite. So that's how I was so hesitant to recite, and then they started, you know, listening and taking out the mistakes. And with our mistakes we learn. Don't think, oh no, I'm gonna be good. No, don't think that. We will have our mistakes. Even my good teacher, she still says, no, I'm learning. When you will be a student, you will learn, and we will be a student till we die. From Lahad to Mahad to Lahad. Mahad is like, you know, when baby is born in that cradle, and Lahad is like how the you know, grave will be. That's how it is. So today we're going to learn one rule called izhar. So what is izhar? Izhar from zahara. Zahara means clear. Izhar is something you are pronouncing very clearly. So I'm going to write the letters. What are the izhar letters and how we're going to do it, inshallah. So izhar is like, you know, whenever noon sakina, like this is the noon sakina, or tanween, you know this tanween, dammatain, fatatain or kasratain, this comes, this or this. You can see in the mushaf also, whenever the noon sakina or tanween, tanween can be dammatain, fatatain or kasratain, it can be anything, whenever this thing is there. There are 6 letters which comes, then you have to read it clearly. Izhar means reading clearly, making it very clear. The same word we use in Urdu also, izhar, make it clear. Okay? What are the, how does, like, you know, after Noon Sakina or Tanween? So there are six letters. Hamza ha, Ayn ha, Ghain ha. These are the letters of izhar. Against these letters, you know, they subdivide. Like how they subdivide, I'm going to tell you later. But right now, just we'll stick to this rule. Whenever Noon Sakina or Tanween comes, these letters we have to look for. And then what we have to do? We don't have to read it with nasal sound. No. We have to read it clearly. That is how the izhar is. Izhar means saying it clearly. Saying Noon Sakina and Noon Tanween, it clears, like we don't have to hide the sound. We have to say it clearly. Inshallah, we'll see in the today's lesson what we can take out some examples. Before that, I'm going to give you some examples. So, وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدْ. When we say hasidin, when you see a hasidin, hasidin has kasratain. See? When we say ha, it has kasratain. Then hasidin, when we say hasidin, then we have to say iza. So how we gonna say iza? After saying hasidin, we gonna say this clearly. We are not going to hide that voice. Hasidin iza hasad. And salamun hiya matla'il faj. Salamun. Salamun has dammatain. Salamun. And then after that, hiya. Ha is there. So here, what is there from this? Six alphabets, Hamza. There we have, here, ha is there. Same thing, walayalin, ash, in Surah Fajr. So, layalin, then after that, ash, ayn. See, the letter ayn is there. Okay. Tasla naran, tasla naran. Hamia. Hamia, we're going to say clearly. We are not going to hide. Just how you read it, just you're going to read it that way. You're not going to do the nasal sound. So I was looking for Noon Sakina. Any Noon Sakina is there, you know. There we can look in our today's lesson, inshallah, otherwise. Yeah, Fasalli li Rabbika one har. One har. One, we have Noon Sakina. Then after that, ha is there. So we can say one har. Noon Sakina. So, Khalaq al insana min alaq. In min, we have that Noon Sakina. Min. Alaq. Again, ayn is coming. So we're going to read it clearly. Inshallah, I'll take out today, we're going to do Surah Baqarah ayat. So let me see how we can look for some Noon Sakina. So I'm looking from starting. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. From Alif Lam Mim, we'll see. Alif Lam Mim, Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fihi Hudallil Muttaqin. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. If you see anything in this Surah Baqarah, let me know. Here ulaika ala hudam is there, but there is no six letters like what we learned today. There is no hamza ha, ayn ha, ghain ha. We have to have that. In Minan Nasi also, May Yakulu, again we don't have that, those letters. So this is, that's the reason I took out these examples. I don't see much in this. It has to have those six letters. Sawaun alayhi. I use this, Sawaun. Yes, that's correct, Sawaun. Excuse me, not Quran, Muslim one. Any other? Let's see, when we... Azabun Aleem. Like here, Summun Bukmun. After Bukmun, we have this Tanween, then Ain is there. We have to read it clearly. Book mun, then ayn is there. Om yun. We will read clearly. We'll look for noon sakina inshallah in our lesson today. That's the reason I took out these examples from the Juz 30th. I don't see much of it here. Inshallah. When we are doing lesson, we'll see. You remember we started Surah Baqarah and we did till the second category of Kafirun. We did Muslimun, like those who have Fala. And then we have gone through 6 and 7 ayah. Then we have seen the son of some of the things in hypocrites. So I'm just going to review 5 minutes about this lesson, like what we did previously. So we started with Surah Fatiha, we completed Surah Fatiha, and we have seen the importance of Surah Fatiha. Surah Fatiha is, you know, is a surah which has different names, and Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, like this is the only surah which was revealed whole of 7 ayahs together. And this is called Shifa also, because we read it and we blow on the water and drink it. And there are two different opinions on this. Some says you can do it, some says we can't. But we have seen Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he blows, and you know when the spit, some of the, you know, that when you recite something, it is in your mouth and you blow it, that will be in your water and you can have it. So, you know, when you are reading it, that is getting transferred. Scientifically, if you see that thing, how the things are, so it has that weight, right? So, our Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, whatever he did, we are just doing the Ittiba'e Rasul. So, it has different names. One of the names is called Ruqya, Ash-Shifa, and Sabaul Masani. These are the 7 ayahs which recites again and again. How we recite again and again? In our Salah. When Imam is reciting, we repeat after Imam, even in our heart, when even in the Fard prayer. But again, there is two different opinions. Some people, they don't recite it and they listen calmly. But reciting is, that's how we learn from Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. In teens class, we are learning how the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to do the prayer. We are learning how the prayer should be. Everybody knows how to pray, just we want to make it more good and more khushu for that. So everybody has to recite Surah Fatiha. Without Surah Fatiha, our salah is incomplete. And if we listen it carefully, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem, Bismillah Ar-Rahman, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. We are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and hamd is such a kind of praise which is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hameen dal hamd. Alhamdulillahi is for Allah. We are sitting here for the sake of Allah. Lillahi. Rabbil Alameen. He is the Rabb of Alameen. Alameen is the plural of Alam. And Alameen is two worlds or more than that, you know. So this is plural. We are not talking about dual. We are talking about vast. So if we die, there also Allah is there, our Lord, and here also. So, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin. Rahman and Rahim both have the same root word, Rahameen. And you know, most merciful, always all merciful. We have seen the difference between Rahman and Rahim. Rahman is on the weight of Falam, more emphasis, and Rahim. Like one is merciful in this world for the non-Muslims and Muslims, and the other mercy is for the hereafter also. That time we need mercy. And only one mercy, one rahmah is there in this world. So see how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful. 99 mercy is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only one mercy here. Maliki Yawmiddin. Maliki mean lamta. Maliki Yawmiddin. He is the Malik. He is the he owns it for the day of judgment. Maliki Yawmiddin, Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in. He is the only one. He only guides, and we ask only him for our help. We don't ask any other. So here, abandoning the shirk, completely closing the door for the shirk. Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in. Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. Guide us, show us the path which is straight. Ananta alayhim. This is the core of the surah. An'amta alayhim. We want the guidance of on which you have bestowed mercy, which you like it. We want to be an'amta alayhim. Ghayril maghdub. We don't want ghayril maghdub, which you get angry. Maghdub is from ghadab. We don't want any ghadab, anger. And we don't want to be astray. Dalin is from dalala. Duad lam la. This is the third category. We want to qualify in first category. So we are asking, we are begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe more than 14 times in a day, like show us the straight path, which is you bestowed mercy. And not the ghadab, not the dalin. What is the difference between ghadab and dalin? Ghayr al maghdub. Some of them, they gain knowledge, but they didn't implement it. Okay, they gain knowledge, maghdoob, but they didn't implement. It can be Jews or Christians when they have given the book. What about the Muslim people? The same thing for us. Like, you know, we are not saying this. This ulama, which you call it scholar, they spent years and years studying the Quran. And that's how we get the core from it. We are not saying anything from our heart, which we call it hawa, our desires. No, this is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here I have written notes, and these notes are from Ibn Kathir, Sahih Muslim, all the things has been compiled and given the notes. So I wrote it, and with my mind I am saying, but it's written here. But if you want to refer to the online, if you give the Ibn Kathir, you will have that app also. It's like $3 or $4, I think. But it don't have that much detail, but it has some details on it, Ibn Kathir. And Q Tafsir is also there, qtafsir.com. If you go there, qtafsir.com, there also you can see Ibn Kathir. But if you have that volume, that has more detail in it. Today I didn't get it, but Ibn Kathir, it has 10 volumes in it. So here, when we are asking in Surah Fatiha, we are asking for the person on the Sahaba when bestowed mercy. We don't want ghadab and dalin. Like, you know, we are gaining knowledge and we are not implementing. No, no, no. We don't want that. Dalin, they don't gain knowledge, they don't implement it. They are complete dalin. Like, you know, when you spell it, da, like how you are raising the tongue, and dalin, we are saying. So when you are spelling also, you could feel that It's like a complete dalala, complete asterisk. We don't want that. And here, alif lam mim, like, you know, when we start Surah Baqarah, this says, you know, Surah Baqarah is Madani Surah. And in Madani Surah, the ahkamat are different. Surah Fatiha was Makki Surah. So let me tell you the difference between Makki and Madani. Makki is before Hijra and Madani is after Hijra. These Makki Surah, there will be more focused on Aqeedah, oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Madani Surah, what all the things we can do? Like, you know, all the ahkamat of talaq, how the daily life should be, what we should do, what we shouldn't do. Imperative things will be there in Madani Surah. But Makki Surah, more straight. Okay, this is the thing. You know, believing in one Allah. Don't do shirk. Don't do that. You know how the clear things will be there. Just now we have seen in Surah Fatiha. I just summarized it because already we did this. Just want to make sure everything we know and then we can proceed with our lesson. If we don't know the previous thing, then again we are lacking. So I'm just skipping it. And in Madani Surah, Surah Baqarah, here, you know, when we recite Surah Baqarah, whether you recite it with your hafizah, with your memory, or whether you see and recite it, shaitan will go away. And what thing we have seen? Surah, those who recite Surah Baqarah, shaitan will go away. And this is the thing, on the day of judgment, they will come like birds, or the umbrella, or the cloud, which will shade you. And why we need shade on that day? Because heat will be on the peak. You can't even imagine, like, just think about, like, little bit, 100 degrees are there, and how we feel it without any shade. Just imagine you are walking barefoot. You are not wearing anything. How it will be? Have you you have visited Makkah and Medina? Just walk without anything in your feet. How you feel it? You could feel that heat. This will be more intense. So we want shade that day. So if you recite it, Surah Baqarah, Ale Imran, the shade will be there. Whether in kind of birds or clouds or umbrellas, but we want shade, everybody, right? So if you try to memorize it, at least few ayahs, like, you know, especially last ayahs of Surah Baqarah, that beneficial you, like, at the time of night when you are sleeping, if you recite those ayahs, those are good for you, you know, it will keep you protection. And if you make it a habit, it's a good thing, you know. You can, and Surah Baqarah also, like, if you memorize it, it's good. If you can't memorize it, just daily do some. You can complete at least in 1 week or 2 weeks, depends. Everybody has their own intensity. Please don't compare in this. How much you can do it, do it. And sometimes, you know, you have mistakes because some words are very hard to pronounce it. Listen to the Qari. Mishari Rashid is free in Quran Explorer. If you go and download Mishari Rashid, you can play any time in Quran Explorer. And their font is also good in Quran Explorer. I noticed that. And you can make it how much big you want. And this is how you can recite it. Here, when the Surah Baqarah starts, it starts with hurufe muqattat, disjoint letters, alif lam mim. But some people, they try to take out the meaning of it. Alif means Allah, lam means Jibreel, mim means Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But this is not authentic. Okay, people say that, but it's not authentic. So we are not going to talk about what is not authentic. Just I am mentioning that because when you somebody will say, okay, this is the thing, then you can reply to them, no sister, this is not, this is how hurufu muqattat, it don't have any meaning. Allah knows the meaning. And whenever hurufu muqattat, most of the times it talks about kitab, it talks about book. So here also alif lam mim, zalikal kitabu la raiba fihi udallil muttaqin, zalika, this is the book which, you know, Al-Kitab. Al-Kitab, here talking about Quran. La Raiba Fi, there is no doubt. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly says in the starting, there is no doubt. And we have discussed about Raib also. Ra, Ya, Ba. Raib is such a doubt which make you restless. Which make you restless. Ra, Ya, Ba. Fihi Hudal Lil Muttaqeen. Al-Muttaqeen. So this is for the muttaqin. What is muttaqin? Those who have taqwa. And taqwa is from waw, qaf, ya. Allazina yuminuna. Now the qualities of muttaqin are there. And we want to qualify in those qualities. Allazina yuminuna bil ghaib. This is the first quality. We discussed this and I put on the board also. You remember I marked one for the bil ghaib. And then second for wayuqimuna salata. First, we believe in unseen. Then we establish salah. We are not just doing salah. وَيُقِيمُونَ السَّلَاةَ. This also explains قَامَ يَقُومُ. Establishing, making his salah. How we should do it on the proper time, proper tahara, proper etiquette, and how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us that way. If you pray on time, it has as if you earn 100 out of 100. You know, we want to make a habit praying on time, because Allah loves if you pray on time. But if you have that, you know, excuse, sometimes you are busy, that's okay. But your intention should be, you should make it a habit to pray on time. If you delay also, don't delay so much that the prayer time is going off, and you know, don't make it a habit. Sometimes it's excused. And you know, just doing fard at least, fard if you do small surahs, like if you are really busy, do with small surahs, but do with the khushu. Whether you are doing with khul also, that's okay. But keep yourself with the wudu so that you do on the time. As-salat. Mimma razaqnahum yunfikhun. We have seen this. Mimma razaqnahum yunfikhun. Nafaka, noon fa qaf. You remember nafaka, noon fa qaf. It's a tunnel which is open from both sides. Nafaka is such a tunnel which is open from both sides. So what is the difference? Like, you know, what is yunfikhun? Like spending. When you spend, it comes from this side and goes from this side, yunfikhun. And same, the root word has been mentioned for the munafikhun. Munafik, what they do, like munafik, hypocrite, iman goes in and exits it. So this is a tunnel which minds resides, and they go from one place and exits from other. So that's how the Arabs, they name it, yunfikhun. And we discuss about what is literal meaning and what is the linguistic meaning. We have seen that also. And وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَبِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُقِنُونَ. This here we are talking about what book has been mentioned, revealed before the Quran. We believe in that also. We do, right? But we are talking about which is clear one, not the one which they make changes. So we are talking about the books which is clear. And wabil akhirati hum yuqinun. And they believe in the eternity. So they believe in eternity on the last day. Actually they come here for volunteering, you know. Alhamdulillah, they help here, mashallah. But sometimes we have to tell them. So here, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem, Bismillah Rahman Rahim. So after mentioning all this, وَبِالْ آخِرَةِ هُمْ يُخِنُونَ. And they believe in Akhirah with conviction. You know, when you close your eyes and you think, oh, this is the thing. It happens. Like, you know, sometimes our children, they do mistake and somebody says, oh, she's lying. Or you say, no. She can't. She never lies. She is so good. How our belief is, that's how we are saying no. With conviction, with complete conviction, we are saying no. Whom you know, we believe in hereafter. We all do. Because that's the thing we are, you know, trying our best to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy. So here with conviction, وَبِلْ آخِرَةِ هُمْ يُقِنُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pointing such people. These are the muflihun. And muflihun also, we have seen the detail of muflihun. فَلَاحَ is the root word. فَلَامْحَ. فَلَاحَ يَفْلِحُ is, you know, being successful. فَلَّح, if you say فَلَّح, it's for the farmer. When farmer put a seed, it will take time to, you know, gradually it will grow. You have to nourish it. How it will be successful? The same mufli hoon is such kind of success. Here gradually we are nourishing our plant in our heart and how it will be successful. That's how the mufli hoon will be. Falaham. Inna lazina kafaru sawaun alayhim. A anzartahum am lam tunzirhum la yuminun. As for those who reject faith, it is same whether you warn them or not, you don't, they will not believe. Inna lazina kafaru. Here say inna, indeed. Allazina, those who. At least we can, today we can memorize these two words. Last time also we did, remember? Inna, indeed. So inna is indeed. So if this inna comes, same thing, but if comes with alif, it means indeed we. Inna is different, inna is different. Okay? So here we have seen inna lazina kafaru. Sawaun is equal alayhim upon them. Anzartahum. Anzartahum is from nazara. This attribute of nazara, warning, noon, zal, ra, nazara. So nazara is warn them. Anzartahum, nazara, warning them. So when whether you warn them or anzartahum, same root word, nazara, same, noon, za, ra. Noon, za, ra. Nazara, same thing, when you say nazara, nazir also with this. It means, warn. Have you noticed whenever Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam we talk about Nazir and Bashir, these two things. Here saying Nazar, Anzar Kavut. Whether you warn them or not, La Yuminu, they won't believe. La also easy to remember. La means not. La. Not, no. But there is difference between La and Lam. Okay, this is just La. It has alif also. So, if we memorize small words, when we read Quran, it's easy for us, inshallah. Easy to remember like what it says. And kafaru also so easy to remember, when we are saying kafaru, it's from kufur. So small words we try to focus on, and here whether you want them or not, it says they are not going to believe. Why is it so? Because that's how they are, they are not going to believe. But here we are talking about kafaru. Like, people who disbelieve. This is the second category. First was the muflihun. They were the successful, and we categorized in the other class how the attributes will be. In the lazina, like what they believe in, unseen, they establish salah, and they spend money. And in yunfikun, they spend, tangible, intangible way. This is also yunfikun. Okay? Like spending time also yunfikun. Everything comes yunfihun, whether we are doing for the children, for our community, but our intention should be lillah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here, next ayah comes, ayah number 7, Qatama. Qatama is also easy to remember. Today at least we try to memorize 5 words, very easy. Then we can focus more on the Quran, translation in tafsir. Qatama, this word also inshallah, easy to remember. Ha-ta-ma. So, Fatima is like, it's from ha-ta-mi. So, this is very easy to remember. Fatima. It's like, seal. It's such kind of seal, nothing can go inside and nothing can come out. It's like, if you pour something on it, nothing will go inside. Khatama is such kind of seal. Ala kulubihim. And what is there? Where the seal is? On kulubihim. Kulubihim from qalb. Paaf lamba. Kulubihim is from qalb. Allah sam ihim. And we have seen this in detail, how the hearing has been stopped, wala aksarin, and on that what it is there? Rishawa is there. Rishawa is there. Okay? And it's such kind of way, you can, you know, how we put our hijab and see, okay, whether you see the hair or not. Like, something you can see. It's not like complete way, something still you can make out what it is. Okay? Rishawa is such kind of way. Balahum azabun azim. Because of that, they have azabun azim. This has a big, great punishment. Please notice here it says azabun azim. Later on we'll see azabun alim. How the things changes. How the punishment changes. This is for the inna lazina kafaru. Because they deny it. For inna lazina kafaru, what are the things they have? You want or not, it will be seen. First thing, for kafaru, these are the things for kafaru. First thing, you won or not, they will be saved. They won't believe. And second thing in this is, khatam Allahu ala qulubihim. There is seal on their heart. Second thing, seal on their heart. Seal on their heart, and their few more faculties have been mentioned. Just not the heart, sam'ihim and absarihim. Eyesight also mentioned and ears also has been mentioned. But the same word has been used, rishawa, both of them. For the eyes and ears, rishawa has been mentioned. So for third thing, you know, eyes and ears have veil. So this veil is such kind, still you can hear some or still you can see something, okay? So here, walahum azabun azim. Because of this, all these three things, what is the end result of it? Azabun azim. And this azabun azim is, you know, is the punishment, big punishment. This is big punishment. Why I am writing this? Because we will see another category after this. Till now, this is the kafur. We have seen the muflihun in detail, so I am not writing today. And then after that, what happens? وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ. This is the thing in ayah number 8, you see, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ. And among the people, here woman last, we are talking about people, the mankind. May yakunu amanna. There are some people who say, we believe in Allah. There are some people who say, we believe in Allah. He yawmi ahiru wa ma hum bi mu'minin. The last day, yet they are not believing. There are some people among them, we are talking about people.
So they are going to come in to get the water bottles?
Yeah, sure. Okay. So here, we are talking about the third category. So these are the people, they say they believe, and amanna billahi wa bil yawmil akhir. They believe in the last day, wa ma hum bi mu'minin. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, no, they are not believers. Why is it so? Let's see the preceding ayah. Yuqadi'un allaha. They deceive Allah. Yuqadi'un allaha. It's just not yufadiyunna. It is with Allah. Ayah number 9. Yufadiyun Allah is from Fada'ain. Fada'a. You know, this is like, you know, deceiving. Yufadiyunna Allah, they deceive. Here when they deceive, Alladheena amanu wama yaghdawuna illa anfusahum wama yashkurun. They, Allazina amanu, the believers, however, they deceive none except themselves. Yet they do not realize it. This thing we have to understand. First, half of it, we'll understand first. Yufadi'una Allah. They deceive Allah. People, those who say they believe, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, no, they are not believers. Allah is saying. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about those people they are deceiving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Allah is talking about them. And then verb is connecting us. Verb is and. This is also easy to remember, verb. And. But sometimes verb can be by for the person. Okay? But here is for and. Sometimes it can be for while. Verb has three meanings, and, by or while. But here verb is for and. Alladhina amanu. And those who believe. Vama yaqda'una. While. See, before this verb was and. But in the same ayah, vav with fatha has while. W-H-I-L. While. Ma is not. But just now I said la is not. Right? But here I am saying ma is not. So there is one rule. Write it down. Ma is not when illa comes next. See in the ayah? Ma is not because illa is there. Because of that, we are doing it not. Ma. Simply, if you. Ma. Not. But depends, do you have illa or not in the preceding ayah? If you have illa. Illa, if you have that except, what you call it, then only this will be not. Otherwise, what will be? Here it is not, but sometimes ma can be what. But in this case, it is not. Ma yabda'una illa anfusahum wa ma yashkurun. Illa is exception. Except. Who is saying? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about these people. Except anfusahum wa ma yashkurun. Except they deceive themselves and they do not perceive also. And here, yaqda'una, they deceive. But you have seen, if you notice in ayah number 9, yuqadi'una, yaqda'una. But we are translating both of them, they deceive, they deceive. This is the beauty of Arabic. It changes the meaning, but sometimes it is same. Sometimes the same word has opposite meaning also. But here it is not. It has the same meaning. But one using for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one using for the people. Whenever we are using anything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like in Urdu we say aap. But in English, we translate it you only. But in a respectful manner, sometimes we say we. It doesn't mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to. No, no, no. It's for the honor. So here, when we are using for yuqadiruna Allah, they deceive Allah. They are thinking they deceive Allah. Wa alladhina amanu, and those who believe, wa ma yabdawuna illa anfusahum wa ma yashkurun. But they are actually deceiving themselves. But they don't even perceive. Yashkuruna is from sha'ar. This word you have to understand. Sheen and ingra. Sha'ar is used for hair. This is the literal meaning, hair. Sha'ar, sheen and ra. If you say sha'ar, it means hair. But here we are saying yashkurun, perceive, right? Again, remember the rule? Literal meaning, linguistic meaning. So literal is hair. But linguistically, it means how the hair will be very thin. The perceiving it thinly, very minorly. That's how the perceive it is. So, Arab people, they took this meaning as perceiveness, perceiving. So here the meaning will be perceiving. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, they are saying that they are deceiving, and they are deceiving me. No, no, no. They are deceiving themselves. They don't even realize. You understand what I mean? If you have questions, please let me know. Okay. The same thing. Now, what they first thing they did? They deny, and you know they are thinking they are believers, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is denying, saying no, they are not. And second thing, on that. Note, after that it says, They have disease in the heart. But when we call maradun, you know, dhammatain, there is a disease. It can be nakira, it can be any kind of disease. Okay? There is a disease. What kind of disease? We don't know. It's not like, you know, certain kind of, it is nakira, it can be anything. And what, and on top of that, what it is? فَجَادُهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَدَى. And that disease, فَجَادُهُ, is from زِيَادَى. زَيَادَى. It means the disease has been increased. Let me put the things, like, you know, how we take the suffer. But this is the third category. And let me explain to that. In Makkah, there are two categories. Muslim and Kafir. But when came to Medina, there was one more category called Munafiqun. And in Medina, there was a person called Abdullah bin Ubay. He was a Munafiq. And he was preparing to be a leader. He was preparing to be a leader. That time, Rasulullah was from Medina. And everybody, you know, respect him, appreciate him, and nobody cares about Fatima Bintey. And now he has that thing in his heart, you know, maradun. And because of that, this is the category talking about munafiqun. Munafiq, they pretend they are Muslim. They believe, but they are not. So here you're talking about one munafiq, but they were lot. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveal the whole, you know, detail about Munafiqun and all the list, how many Munafiq were there. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows the whole year. But he was about to tell the people, he came out and he was about to tell, and somebody was fighting outside. And he forgot completely. And there is a hikmah, there is a wisdom behind it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't feel it. Umar Khattab knows and some of the Sahaba know, but they also didn't feel. But this is the munafiq, we know everybody, this is Abdullah bin Ubay. But never ever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned anybody's name. You know, this is munafiq, this is kafir. Have you noticed in the whole Quran? So we are not supposed to say anyone, oh, he is munafiq, he is kafir. And you know, in India, if you call it kafir, it's like a bad word. They will, you know, charge you something. You can't call them because they think that we are calling kafir just to mock him, just to humiliate him. They made such kind of thing. So we are not supposed to call people with the names, you know, that it will hurt them. In Surah Gujarat also, we learn so many, you know, aspects of the community, how the things should be. So here, we are going to talk about munafiq. First thing, they deceive, but they don't even realize. Yukadimun. First thing. This is for the munafiq. So first thing, deceiving. And the second thing, and you know, fi qulubihim marad. They have disease in their heart. Disease in the heart. And this subdivide, disease in the heart, fazadahum allahu marada. This disease, it increases. So this, I will put it A, it increases. I'm not going to categorize again because it is subdivided. And because of that, because of these things, fazadahum, you can see in the ayah, azabul aleem. They have azabul aleem. You remember in previous ayah, what was that? Azabul Azim. It was big. Aleem is pain. Here they have painful punishment. Pain is like, you know, if I have pain, nobody knows that I am going through pain. So this is like a painful thing they are going through. And ayah is not ended. Bima kanu yaksibun. What was the reason for that? They have this, but bima kanu yaksibun. Finally, they are liars.
vyakti bhumikate, they lie. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says because they were lying, so they have this punishment. Even though you qadi huna they were doing, they were deceiving. First of all they said we believe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says no. They are deceiving me, but they are deceiving themselves. Then fi qulubihim marad. Fazaruhum illahu marada. Then azabul ali bima kanu yaksibun. This is how the thing is. So in this way, we can understand in a better manner. So it doesn't mean that first we should check ourselves. Are we? I have to check myself. Am I doing yakdauna? Or do I have fikulubin maravun? Do I have disease in my heart? What kind of disease is it? It can be anything, jealousy, lying, that's like, you know, bima kanu yaksibun. Or you know, it can be backbiting, or it can be, you know, always cribbing and, you know, not happy. Sometimes, you know, they live in a kind of grief, sorrow. They make it a habit. As if, you know, some people, they drink something, alcohol or smoke. That kind of manner I have seen some people, they will be sad and sad, that grief overcomes them. And they take the medicine and they live in that way. Nobody can help them because they have to have themselves. They have to come out of it. Eating medicine and sleeping doesn't work, right? So this also is kind of disease. Why it is called disease? Because you are not happy with yourself. You can lack in anything in the worldliness. Maybe somebody may have that much money, or somebody may not have, you know, all the worldly things what others have. But it doesn't mean that you are unhappy. This is not the, you know, you are happy what Allah has given you. Can I say to somebody like, you know, oh, look at her and she is having so much and I am not having. Who I am to judge to anyone, right? Whether they are Muslim or not. It is between Allah and her. Why should I judge them? And why should I feel jealous? Jealousy is possible in only two things. If somebody is gaining their knowledge and implementing it for the sake of Allah, lilla, not for the riyah. Second thing, if somebody has lot of money and spending for the sake of Allah, lilla, in these two categories. Other than that, jealousy will burn your bodies. Okay? And what about the backbiting? As if you are eating the flesh of your brother. Who wants to? You feel dislike, you feel ew, that's so bad, we don't want, right? And you know what happens? It's not only Islam teaches us, all the other religions, they never promote us. Backbiting or talking negative, talking ill things, or mocking somebody, humiliating somebody. No, this is not good. And these are the things that affect on your body and that leads to people who give you maradun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said al-mar, no. Maradun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used nakira. And you know, one word, sometimes even dhamma fatta tasa changes the whole meaning of it. So here try to understand, it says maradun, disease. And because of that, azabun ali. And then later on in ayah number 11, فَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. For when it is said to them, do not make mischief on earth. فَالُوا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْلِحُونَ. They say, we make peace. When they were said, don't make mischief on the earth. They say, no, we are making peace. We are not making any mischief. So this kind of attitude is like, you know, it shows the arrogance. If one person is, you know, is saying, okay, this is the thing, you have problems, that is the thing. No, it's not there. You know, completely denial, you are living in denial. If some person say, okay, this is the thing, other person say, oh no, I have that. I'll try to improve. But it's not so yet. They are living in the denial. They're saying, no, it's not so. It means that here وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Don't make mischief on the earth. Mischief on the earth
can be physically or it can be tangible and intangible way. What are the physical way? We know, like, you know, making the, like, you know, destroying the vegetables, fruits, or, you know, bombing or using the guns, all these things we know. But intangible way, like, you know, in the family, somebody is talking on your back and saying, oh, she's not good. And when you are going in that family, you don't have that respect. And that how facade spreads. Same thing in our community. When you are talking on the back and in the front you are good, that's how facade spreads. A community affected, the whole society affects. So this is also a facade. And Kalu innama nahnu muslim. Who is this people? They don't even recognize the problem. Like, you know, you go to the doctor and she says, okay, you have this problem, and then you go through the test and finally, you know, this is the problem. But somebody is saying, denying on the first time, no, I'm not going to do the test. I'm good, alhamdulillah. What is it? It means complete denial. So here, and following ayah, Ala innahum humul mufsiduna wala killa la yashurun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah is beware. It's like a harfe tambi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry. Allah, innahum humul mufsidun. They are the ones who make mischief. And again, you know, remember, deceiving also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they are deceiving themselves. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no, humul mufsidun. They are the people who is making mischief. Wala killa la yashurun. Again, the same word has been used, yashurun. They do not have even realized it. But here, when you translation, if you see, first we are saying perceiving. Here we are saying realize it. We are translating in a different manner, but same word has been used. Yashurun, same. Dhamma, fatha, kasra. There is no change in the word. But here also yashurun. But before we say perceive. But now we are saying realize it. Because depending on the ayah, we are going to change the meaning. Daraba, sometimes example, daraba is walking. So depends on the ayah, we are going to change the meaning. So when we have that test or assignment, we have to be careful how we are translating it. Especially the word meaning. So they don't even realize it. First, they don't even perceive it, the previous one. But here, they don't even realize it. And later on, what else is there? Wa'iza, and when? Wa'iza qila lahum aminu kama amana nasu qalu anuminu kama amana sufaha. Ala innahum humus sufaha wala killa la yalamun. So when it is said, Wa'iza, and when? He is told to them, believe as others believe. They were asked, believe as others believe. So what they are saying, you know, they are saying sarcastically. They are not saying humbly, they are saying sarcastically. Should we believe like fools? Fools believe like, you know, kamak amana sufaha? Like fools one? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again using the Allah, beware. It's a harfe tambi. Unquestionably, beware. Unquestionably, they themselves are the fools. If only they could understand. See, we use yashurun two times. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used wala killa la yalamu. They know. They, la means not, right? Do not. They do not know what they are doing. So it means that it is told them, like, after having all these things, again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving chance. Okay, now believe it. And again they are saying, no, we don't want to believe like foolish one. Sufaha is from Safi. Safi is like, you know, very light-minded person. Safi, like, you know, if you have light-minded person, like, you know, it can blow away. If your intellect is not that much, that's how the Safi is, foolish ones. So, they are calling Mominoon the foolish. They are thinking themselves very smart. And this is the quality of Munafiqun. Every time, you know, they portray themselves good and they portray others humiliating position. So we have to check ourselves. Are we doing that? All the things what we have seen in previously, are we doing that? So here, inshallah, we're going to stop here on ayah number 14, inshallah. And وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا قَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّ مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَحْزِئُونَ. And then لَقُوا, لَقُوا is from لَقِيَا, لَام قَافِيَا, لَقِيَا, meet. الَّذِينَ دُوزُ. And you know, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, this is also easy to remember. الَّذِينَ means دُوزُ. آمَنُوا, they believe. الَّذِينَ دُوزُ, آمَنُوا, they believe. قَالُوا, they said, آمَنَّا, we believed. وَإِذَا قَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ. And when they are alone with the shaitans, they say, we are the really with you, we were only mocking with the believers. Actually, they didn't believe it, but in ayah number 14, when they meet the amanu, when they meet the people, and they say, qalu amanna, we believe. When they see like-minded people, like, you know, those who believe, they say, okay, we believe. As soon as, va'iza qalau, when they are alone with the shaitans, you have seen the word shayateenihim, it's more, like it's not one shaitan, two, more. But why we are using people to shaitan? It means their mind is like shaitan. Okay? It's not literal shaitan. Their mind is like shaitan, corrupted. Shayateenihim. What they say? Qalu innama maakum nahnu mustahziun. Just we were mocking. Mustahziun is from huzwa. You know, you are making fun of somebody. Oh, she's tall, she's short, she's dark. That kind of comment you are doing and making fun of them, that is huzwa. Mocking somebody with you know, some names, and you are try to taking out their behavior or their action or their face, something you are taking out and you are naming them and you are laughing at that thing. That's how they are mustahziun, huzwa, ha, zai, hamza. They are laughing at them. So this is the thing they are doing it. I think here the topic ends, so let me complete this ayah 15 also. Allahu yastahzihu bihim wa yamudduhum fi tughyanihim yamahun. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah will throw back their mockery on them and leave them alone in their trespassing or transgression. Allahu yastahzihu. Allahu Allah. Yastahzihu is from same root word which is mustahziun. Ha, zai, hamza. He mocks. But mustahziun, once who mocks. But yastahziu, he mocks. How the words changes. If you buy this workbook, it is easy to memorize. If you memorize each word 7 times, you can do it, inshallah. That's how we did. Bihim, at them. Vayamudduhum is from madda yamuddu. Yamuddu is from meem dalda. Stretching lengthwise. But here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he extends. He is extending the time. You know how the time limit extends? In what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is extending the time? In tughyan, in rebellion, in transgression, in crossing the limits, Allah is leaving them. You know, whatever they do, let them do. Allah is leaving on their own. Fi tughyanihim. And what? How the ayah acts? Ya mahun. Like, you know, they wander blindly. They are not, actually, they are not ama. They are not literally blind. But you know, when you are so much engrossed into the worldly things, they lost the hidayah. Like today, dua, Allahumma alhimni rushdi faizni. So they lost the rushd. They lost hidayah. They are in yamahun now. So we don't want to be in yamahun. Like they are wandering blindly in their own. These kind of people, they justify themselves. You know, there is a thing called in our soul which try to tell you more times, no, you are doing wrong. It keeps on giving you signal from our heart to our mind, and we keep on rejecting it. And sometimes we don't even sleep, and then we take sleeping pills and we started consoling our soul. Oh, no, you are good. Yeah. But you are not answering the question. So you are rejecting that. So that's the reason that fazaduhum and then yamahun happened. So how many faculties we covered till now? In our body we are talking about. What are the things we... Like, you know, we talk about heart before that. In the lazina in kafaru. That like how the heart gets blocked. It's like, you know, oh, her heart is blocked. She has to have the open heart surgery. What about the people those heart is sealed and they need to have that cure. How? Quran. If you read Quran, you know, all the rust will go off. So if you don't, if you can't read it, at least try to listen it. At least try to do from Alif Ba Ta Tha. If you, the means are so easy now. You know, when we read Surah Kahf, Zulkarnain is keep on using the Adba Asababa, using the means. Now we got everything. Right from like technology to what not. Khari is reading in, like, you know, where he read, you don't know, but right in front of, in the laptop, in the phone, everywhere. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to ask you, what happened? You had the means. Why don't you read it properly? You know, who read with difficulty, they have 10 times more reward. So don't be shy. So inshallah, next time onwards, we'll focus on tajweed also. How we should recite it. At least the rules, so, like correct way of pronunciation, taking out the words properly. Inshallah, in teens class, we have advantage of Sister Lamia. And she has ijaza, mashallah. And she recites so well, mashallah. And she memorized it. And also she knows all the words. She teaches in Thursday class also. We have Thursday class from 10 to 12:30 in ISD. So there also she listened to each and every person. And then she explained the rules also. And in end we do tafsir. So here, today lesson we did Surah Fatiha. Just I'm going to wind up quickly in 5 minutes. 12:55 will end inshallah. Surah Fatiha, we have been, seen 3 categories. So we want to be one who has bestowed with the mercy. Ananta alayhim we want to be. Ghairil maghdoob we don't want. We don't want the ghadab and we don't want dhalim. And Surah Baqarah we started, we reviewed the few ayahs in the starting. And Surah Baqarah, if you recite it, shaitan will go away. Many people, they say, oh, have sihir. Sihir is possible. One can do on you. And the most important thing we have to remember, on Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it happened. 3 khul, the last, mawazatain. Better to recite all 3 khul and Aytal Kursi. And Surah Baqarah, if you recite it daily, shaitan will go away. And whoever is having the problem of sihir, like, you know, magic or anything, they should pray 5 times daily. That is most important. Many people, they come with this problem. But the only solution is be in wudu, pray properly, but they don't do that. They want shortcuts, which is not possible. And one of the aspects is reciting Surah Baqarah. At least gradually, slowly, daily some ayahs, or at least you can listen it. Concentrating, you know, putting the headphones on and then listening to it. You can do it anywhere, you know, like listening while driving or doing the household chores. And then we started Surah Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fihi Hudal Lil Muttaqin. We have seen what is Muttaqin, Allazina Yuminuna Bil Ghaib Wa Yuqimuna Salata. We have to establish Salah and how the things we have to do in the Salah. This is the most important aspect, Salah. And we're going to focus this Salah, inshallah, in a more detailed manner in other class so that we improve our Salah. Because in the hereafter, the first question will be that. We want 100 marks in that, inshallah. I see, like, you know, in the small things, how we can gain good deeds. Easy way. Like, you know, being a woman, it's easy for some people, you know, they make something and give to the other people. Or they get grocery and give to the, like how the small deeds, but consistency. Like, you know, whether you're putting a dollar in the masjid, consistency is so important. Doesn't matter, 50 cents or dollar, consistency. So because yunfikun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned yunfikun. And I forgot one thing in yunfikun, first is mandatory, zakah. You have to give zakat, no matter what. Sometimes you have to sell your gold and give, take out the zakat. Then comes, you know, whatever the charity you are giving in the akrabain first. Then comes the other circle. In that also, if you are promoting deen, if you are promoting schools, I'm not saying just Islamically, if you are promoting schools and colleges, that also good. And not only that, visiting the people who are sick. It doesn't matter if they are Muslim or not. That is the time they need. You don't know, maybe that moment of time, they will do shahada. you know, that time they want something, you know, something good. We should visit them. We should talk to them. Inshallah, we'll plan in Inshallah. Because we are learning, we are not implementing it. Again, the same thing. You know, the second category. We don't want qadab. And here, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Who is kafaru? Who is denying? This is easy. Like, you know, who is denying? You know in front. But, you know, munafiqun is different. It's hard to identify the munafiq. Kafir is easy to identify. Oh, they say, we yes or no. It's like a black and white. But, you know, munafiq, they are, you know, sometimes say yes and no. Yes and no. They are in the gray area. So, check ourselves. Are we in kafirun? No. Because we are not saying yes or no. Are we in munafiqun? If we are doing, are we doing yakzibuna? Are we denying or lying? Mu'min can't be a liar. You know, sometimes you don't have to answer somebody, it's better. Don't lie. Or sometimes, you know, something you don't want to say, this is the thing, that's okay. But don't lie. And you know, fazaduhum marada, and you know, increasing the marad, we have discussed the whole thing, what is the backbiting, not forgiving. Even not forgiving also increase the disease, you know. If somebody did wrong with you, let them do it. Forgive them. Forgive for the sake of Allah. That makes your heart very light. When I was studying, one of my teachers was saying, okay, forgive everyone. I was saying, no, how is it possible? They don't even ask forgiveness. She said, then also you forgive. I didn't understand that time, you know. Later on, as time goes by, then I realized, oh, this is so good. You know, it feels so good inside your heart. And you keep on saying, Allah, I'm forgiving because of you. And sometimes we yell at our parents and some of our siblings or somebody who is elder to us or younger to us. There's nothing wrong in saying sorry to them. Sometimes to our children, we are really bad to them sometimes. If you say sorry, there's nothing wrong. You know, I notice, like, I learn many things from my elders and also from the children. They taught us so much. Like, you know, when we say, okay, tell them we are not there. They say, oh, mama, you're lying? I notice that, like, they literally, they catch hold of you. That moment of time. And inshallah, we'll try to improve our life. And we will implement this thing. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka natubu ilaik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what was good from it was from you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are the mistakes? It was from me. Please forgive me for that. Jazakallah khairan katheeran.